live along Tennyson Street right now to explain for us.
It's similar to the high-profile Tom's Diner controversy, where the owner made a deal with preservationists to cash in. This funeral home is now the new battleground in the war over property rights versus the desire to defend history.
The community has a lot of history in this building.
Gary Baldwin is on the side of preservation.
It is a great old building. It was built by a master architect.
Baldwin and her allies say they are not against development, but they most certainly are against a wrecking ball.
This building can be reused instead of demolished.
The Olinger Moore Howard Chapel has served North Denver for nearly 60 years. Built by a master architect, it's known for its terracotta tile arches. And it's located on a developer's dream corner, across from Berkeley Lake Park and just north of the Tennyson Business District, an area that has experienced a boom of residential and commercial construction.
I think it can be of many uses instead of tearing it down and building more condos.
Laura has lived in this area since she was 6 years old.
I've seen a lot of changes.
She and everyone else we spoke to along Tennyson support preservation, but there's also a desire and understanding of a property owner's right to have control over their own destiny.
To some extent, that might be a right, but you can't let developers just run wild.
Currently, activists are working toward middle ground similar to the story of Tom's Diner, where the solution allowed for new development that pays homage to the Googie-style architecture of this eatery.
Our Michael Konopasek reporting there. The company that operated the funeral homes located in Texas, their representatives tell us they plan to share development details in the coming weeks. Denver City Council is scheduled to vote on landmark status come November 12th.